Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. Today's video is about lateral periodontal cyst. The lateral periodontal cyst is an uncommon developmental odontogenic cyst, accounting for only 0.7% of all jaw cysts. As the name implies, the lateral periodontal cyst develops along the lateral root surface of a vital and erupted tooth. The cyst is thought to arise from remnants of odontogenic epithelium, which is the epithelium that aids in tooth formation, and its remnants are the cells left behind. The odontogenic epithelial remnants are listed as remnants of reduced enamel epithelium, left after reduced enamel epithelium fuses with the oral epithelium and the tooth erupts into the oral cavity. Remnants of dental lamina, also called epithelial rests of series, which are left after dental lamina detaches from the tooth germ in the late bell stage of tooth formation. And remnants of Hartwig's epithelial root sheet, also called epithelial rests of molasses, left after root of a tooth is formed. Hence, these are the three types of odontogenic epithelial remnants, which when stimulated results in the formation of a cyst. Looking at some clinical points of lateral periodontal cyst, the cyst is mostly asymptomatic and is detected during routine radiographic examination. The tooth with which the cyst is associated is always vital, and the cyst is no more than 1 cm in size. Maxillary and mandibular anterior regions are the most common sites, with the majority of cases occurring in the first premolar, canine, and lateral incisor region of the mandible. Radiographically, the cyst shows small unilocular and teardrop-shaped radiolucent area, located on the lateral aspect of the root. The cyst never caused resorption of adjacent roots, but it may cause divergence of the roots. Although in most of the cases, the cyst has a unilocular appearance, but occasionally the cyst may have a multilocular appearance. Such radiographic appearance is observed in multicystic variant of the cyst, and due to this variant, the cyst is called botryoid odontogenic cyst. In histopathologic features, the cyst has a non-inflamed fibrous wall with an epithelial lining that may be 1 to 3 cell layer thick. In most areas, foci of glycogen-rich clear cells may be interspersed among the lining epithelium. In some cases, the cyst may show focal nodular thickenings of the lining epithelium, which are composed mainly of chief cells. And sometimes the clear cells may be seen in the fibrous wall as well. The treatment for lateral periodontal cyst is careful enucleation of the cyst, and this process can be accomplished without damaging the involved tooth. If you think this video was helpful, please do like, subscribe, share, and comment your questions and suggestions. Thank you for watching.